The first ideas that eventually became the efficient markets hypothesis were postulated by Jules Regnault in 1863. Eugene Fama carried those ideas further in the 1960s, and it became his PhD thesis. Fama recently received the Nobel Prize, so we know those ideas were good. So what's the efficient markets hypothesis about? Let's start by looking at some of the assumptions that it makes. Probably the most important assumption is that there are a large number of investors interacting in the market for profit. So they have an incentive to find opportunities where the price of a stock is out of line with what its true value is. And because there are so many of these investors operating simultaneously, anytime a little bit of information comes out there, the price is going to move. Next assumption is that new information arrives randomly. So it arrives at random times, it arrives at random rates for different stocks, but it's constantly arriving, and investors are paying attention to that information, and therefore the prices are adjusting quickly. Finally, the efficient markets hypothesis assumes that the current price reflects all available information. In other words, all this information that's trickling in is acted upon by the investors. The price adjusts quickly to that information, and the current price reflects all information about that stock.